Hello? Is it me you're looking for?
I bet it is, cause guess what everybody? I'm the assassin AK-47, this is Bulletproof Games, and your boy is back with more of Horizon Zero Dawn. Ladies and gentlemen, what a great video we had last time. We escaped. Yeah, we escaped the Hades. We almost got fucked up there, but hey, we survived it. She had a bad fall, but it was all good. Everything was all gravy. Now we're gonna do this mission: Deep Secrets of the Earth. Go to Sunfall. We almost about to level up. You see that, guys? About to level up to 47. It's gonna be sick. But yeah, man, I cannot wait to see what this mission has to offer. That was a fun one last time.
Sunfall. The Mad King Dran Semipalace. A bulwark of Karja might against the howling Forbidden West.
Thanks for the history lesson.
But they have no idea what lies beneath. We will learn much from this, Aloy.
That's what I'm hoping.
Oh, shit. I said I thought I, you know, finish all the side quests, but look, another one popped up. We go talk to him.
She's very pale. Is she unwell?
Yes. She's a fighter, but the fever on her won't lift. It only burns hotter. Her name is Shiana, my sister.
Isn't there anyone in Sunfall who can help?
We're refugees. We know our place. And there's only one healer in the territory. He's difficult. His soul is in shadow.
His soul is in shadow.
Galiv. That's him. He's very clever, but he has little care for people. Perhaps the desert scoured it all away. Perhaps he was always like that. Either way, I know he won't help us.
Well, I'll see about that. Where would I find him?
Last I heard, he was patching up soldiers at Blazing Arch. Another border battle.
Okay. Healer's death. It's a new era in art.
I'll keep the moon from your...
I'll do that later. Still on to the main mission, guys. The fuck was that? Thank you. I'll take it. There's no telling we'll go find in this place. It seems pretty big, like Meridian. Wait, what? Oh shit, they have like battles? Like bullfights? Like bull ride? Oh shit. I wonder if they try to like tame it, you know, or they're not doing a good job. If that's what they're trying to do.
Now we get to see if your attack on their focus network was entirely successful.
What are you talking about? Did I crash the network or not?
Welcome to the Citadel, Aloy. I'll check back with you in a moment. In the meantime, circulate.
You see that shit? That was weird, wasn't it? Kinda like, that shit just popped up then popped out, like, I don't know. Some weird shit. It's like a glitch or something.
To hear about today's bounties, head for the throne room. You're not going to make any shards by standing out here.
I'll take the shards, even if it means having to listen to Bahavas.
I hear the Shadow Council are looking for one of their own.
Should pay well.
I'm kind of like blending in with them, I guess.
Mm-hmm.
By the glory of the sun revealed. Behold, radiant Edomon, the one true Sun King, the light in shadow, whose will is light and whose light is law.
I command Lucian Bahavas to speak in my behalf.
Aww.
By the will of radiant Edomon does the sun glare down mercilessly upon the traitor Uthid. To the hunter who brings his head to us shall go a bounty of 500 shards.
More prisoners than royalty, don't you think? You and I need to chat, little huntress. The green tent down in Shadowside. I'll be waiting.
Kind of busy.
We both know you don't kill for hire. Uthid is innocent. So come see me while there's still time to save him.
So, the way in I spoke of is right behind you.
You've got to be kidding.
Not at all. And you needn't worry about the Kestrels. They'll be too busy acting important to pay attention to you.
First time in the Citadel. New side quest, Trader's Bounty. So I just got a side quest out of that. Alright.
They want us to see this, boy. It makes quite an
This is insane.
Hardly. The balustrade. It's a short drop from there.
Like, I hate how it does that sometimes. Like, it just cuts. Cuts, like, dialogue goes over some of the other dialogue and it cuts out the other dialogue that I was listening to, but I don't know. It's weird sometimes how it does that. That's why I like, whenever somebody's talking, I usually want to, like, stand still, because sometimes if you move, it'll trigger something else, and, kind of sucks, because you don't get to hear everything they need to, everything they wanted to say, or, because I like hearing everything. Kind of bones me out when I don't. It's alright, I kind of know he's probably goes there. Guess we go down here. Climb down.
The other side of the tower. Look for a vent.
I see you've been here before.
Obviously. Now, it's very important that you hear what I'm about to say. I've shown you the way in, but this humble vent marks a point of no return. Before you descend into the depths here, you should be fully committed, equipped, and focused. No distractions. If you have errands to run, do them first or hold your peace. I won't tolerate whining. Is that clear?
You'll tolerate what I give you, Silence. I didn't ask you along for the ride.
Yeah, sorry for the quick cut, guys. I actually went and did that side quest and that errand, so I went and hurried up and did that because it said, the dude said, hey, if you got any errands and quests you haven't done yet, go do them now because you might not be able to return back. So we might be getting close to the end of the game if that's the case. But it's called Deep Secrets of the Earth. Let's get into it. Yeah, I don't want to show you guys because it'll be the whole video, and I want to like make this video mainly about the main mission. Also, that side quest was pretty cool. It was all right. I mean, basically, the girl talked to us, and we had to help this dude out, and we helped him out, and we killed that little priest guy. And after we killed the priest guy, I had to kill a Thunderjaw and save, like, the mother and the baby, and we had to, like, give them. Basically, we got, at the end of the mission, we got on a boat, and we got the kid and the mother on a boat, and we, like, basically went all the way to Meridian and gave the kid and mother a safe place there, so gave it to the Mad Sun King. That's what happened. But I didn't want to show you because it was just, I wanted this to be mainly about the main story. Like I said, I'm only going to do main story for now on. Y'all seen enough side quests. I mean, most of them are kind of the same. Do this here, kill these machines here, then help this guy out. So that's why I want to do the main missions. Anyways, that's where we left off. Well, last time we saw me, I was right here anyway. Alright, let's do it. Sorry to confuse you. I'm going in.
I'm heading down.
I've spent a lifetime trying to uncover the secrets of this world. Where the machines came from. How the old ones achieved such marvels, only to fall into silence and death. A lifetime of failure. As year by year, decade after decade, I hit walls I could not break, doors I could never breach.
Hello?
Until Honora Huntress marched out of the savage east. And voila, for her, all the deepest secrets of the earth were laid bare. I suspect you will have an easier time with this door than I did years ago.
Hold for identiscan.
Here we go.
Genetic profile confirmed. Entry authorized.
Nice.
Malfunction.
What?
Malfunction.
Are
malfunction.
You kidding me?
You don't hear me laughing.
Shut up. There's gotta be another way. Hey! Elizabeth Sobeck here! Requesting access!
Access request acknowledged. Root command functions available. Do you wish to proceed?
I do! Get me through this door!
Analyzing. Primary access inoperable due to mechanical failure. Emergency venting procedure likely to circumvent blockage. Do you wish to proceed?
Yes.
Emergency venting authorized.
Like, what the hell?
Guess you can't have everything.
That will draw attention. We won't have this place to ourselves for long now.
We? Last I checked, I was the one risking my life down here.
Yes, fine. Now, will you please get moving? There's so much to learn in less time than I'd hoped.
Let's get into it.
Welcome to Project Zero Dawn.
Zero Dawn. We found it.
Are you really so surprised?
Facility diagnostics detect multiple failures. Attempting repair.
So, what was this room?
An entrance hall, perhaps. Have a look around.
You know I will. What do we got? Text mail. This morning, unfortunate incident with Dr. Pogovich is another example of reception's need for additional support. We appreciate that Zero Dawn is an immensely complicated project, but as a staff who serve on the front line, we're tired of being neglected. As we already requested, we need human translators, fluent in Polish, for example. Security staff, we can subdue and engage embryologists, for example. And dermal sedatives to calm persons who are screaming in Polish while hurling chairs and vases and reception staff, for example. Yes, most of these candidates are reasonably calm and well-behaved, but we need help handling the exceptions to that rule. Please respond. Another incident. Damn. One over here. We need a support We need support too. Reception staff continues to require additional support managing ZD candidates with it. When they arrive at the facility, many frightened or confused, some highly agitated. These are not the sort of persons who are accustomed to having information withheld from them. At minimum, we need human translators. The lane bots are not sufficient. And mild sedatives for the extreme cases. Any and all support would be welcome. Perhaps you could start by responding to one of these mails. Okay. Short and straight to the point. I like it.
Please take a seat and wait for your name to be called. A selection of beverages and snacks are available.
In a smaller room.
This is so awesome, guys. Another one. Would it be possible to improve the soundproofing between VR and the lounge area? Most of the candidates stay quiet during the presentation, but the ones who scream or sob can be plainly heard by candidates waiting their turn in the lounge. Just a thought. Soundproofing.
Please proceed into viewing room 1 for an important message regarding the purpose of your visit.
Restock or else. For the fifth time, please restock the large selection of the herbal teas. If If I have to listen to one more egghead throw a tantrum because we're out of the organic cucumber mint or blackberry sage burritos, I'm going to lose it. Please respond, and this time, no tempest in teapot or steam demand jokes, okay? Thank you. Sometimes I like to act like them, or how they would sound like. I'll take all of that, thank you. Anything else in this room? I think not. Let's keep going. We have a mystery to solve.
What was this place?
A holographic theater.
CD01 data intact. Initiating playback.
Welcome to Project Zero Dawn. I am General Harris, Chairman of the Joint Chiefs of Staff of the United States of America. I'm sure you've heard the rumors that Zero Dawn is a top secret super weapons program, the technological miracle that will save us from the Pharaoh Plague, if Operation Enduring Victory can hold off the robots long enough. The reason I'm sure you've heard the rumors is that I'm the one who spread them, and they are all lies. Zero Dawn is not a super weapons program, and it will not save us. Nothing will save us. Here's why. By the time the glitch was noticed, it was already too late. Nothing could stop the Pharaoh Plague. Nothing can. Its robots will continue to replicate and devour the biosphere. Life on Earth will be destroyed. Our planet reduced to a barren sphere. Global extinction is inevitable. No matter how many we kill, the robots just keep exponentially making more. If we had their deactivation codes, we could shut them all down. The entire swarm. But since their cryptographic protocols use polyphasic entangled waveforms, cracking a code set would take half a century. At best, we've got 16 months. Not exactly what you'd call a survival option. The destruction of a biosphere is not the sort of apocalypse you can wait out in a fallout shelter or a space station. There will be no Earth left to reclaim. Just a lifeless, toxic rock with several million Pharaoh robots on it, hibernating, waiting for something to eat. This is the horrible truth behind the lies of Operation Enduring Victory. My lies. Lies designed to inspire millions of innocents to sacrifice themselves in battle. Why? One reason. To buy time for you and the work you will do here. Zero Day, the day that life on Earth ceases to exist, is coming fast. It cannot be stopped. The hope of Zero Dawn is that something new might come after. But I will leave it to Elizabeth Sobeck to shine that thin ray of light into the darkness. Harris.
Wow. Damn. That's crazy.
That doesn't make sense. Life on Earth didn't cease to exist.
You said it could not be stopped.
But it was. Somehow Elizabeth saved us. I've got to keep looking. Find out how she did it.
Yeah, he says not a super weapons program. Like, it's not going to work, so how did she do it? Damn, we got a lot of stuff in here.
They got in through the vents.
Let nothing stop you from learning the truth.
Spread out! If it moves, kill it!
What is this place? Two?
Fuck. Got his ass. Try to take these guys out before I get into those audio logs. Come on, bitch. Oh, fuck. Dead, bitch.
Cloistered and tribal primitives stop us now. The data points, what did they contain?
Being with Suzanne Alpert, environmental scientist. Being with Suzanne Alpert, environmental scientist. Doctor?
I'm sorry, I wasn't,
Just stating your name. What were you thinking about, Doctor?
Nothing the General said, not really. I was on the Syzygy East Response Team in 2051, just after the second earthquake compromised the reactor. I still dream about it, after all these years. The red zone spreading on the imaging, slowly, so slowly, like a hand opening its fingers.
Your involvement in that event is why you were asked for by name.
Really? That's interesting. Because nothing worked. Nothing could grow there again. It was a catastrophic failure. But the red zone is a blip compared to global scale biomass reduction. The biosphere and hydrosphere will collapse, render the Earth uninhabitable long before the robots finish us. Enduring victory can't buy time against that. So, you'd better show me what Zero Dawn really is.
Damn, she's determined. Text log. For the briefing of the presentation, candidates must be allowed to ask questions and be given the necessary time to fulfill the absorbed information they have received. It is important to be aware that candidates have just been exposed to triggers for several mental and emotional trauma. Do not assume silence or outward calmness in case acceptance. It is essential to stress that all other options for combating the feral plague perceiving the continuation of human's life have been considered and found unworkable. Communicate this fact calmly but clearly and firmly. Familiarize yourself with data on the catastrophic environmental impact on nuclear engagements versus a swarm, and the feasibility of maintaining life in orbital, lunar, and undersea structures that you can counter. Hesitation. Be sure to inform security personnel. Security and medical crisis teams are okay. Data up. Got you. We'll check this out over here. Yeah, that interview
is accurate. Yes.
So these mechanical monstrosities—they don't just kill people; they feed off them.
Not just people. All organic matter.
Every living thing dissolves into nutrients. Millennia of evolution liquefied. The miracle of life reduced to bloody biofuel.
In a word, yes.
Who did this? Pharaoh? That asshole. Is he here?
No, Doctor.
Please, tell him Tom Pike wants a word. Now, get off! Get off! Please, you get Ted Pharaoh in here.
Damn, Tom didn't like that, not one bit. Travis Tate.
What to discuss?
Oof. So Mama, she was right.
Pardon?
My mother, she took her Bible real serious. Not just Texas Bubble serious, Pentecostal serious. Favorite chapter? Revelations. Now, I didn't always understand her on account of all that speaking in tongues and such, but when she did use her words, it was always end times this and lake of fire that on account of sinful lifestyles. Speaking of which, mind if I smoke?
A tobacco cigarette.
Sorry, darling. My taste run classic. Compliments your team tracked me down. Been a price on my head 18 months now. Sterling Malky was me, don't mind admitting. Been plenty of snakesters chasing the bounty, too. But I kept the zigging to their zag. How'd you finger me?
I believe Dr. Sobek listed you as an alpha candidate. Priority snatch and grab.
Always suspected she had a little thing for me. Hey, I don't suppose you got real coffee in this place. You know, Blood coffee? Conflict cappuccinos?
Mr. Tate, I'm clearing you to proceed. Just go.
I like that dude. He was funny. Brad.
Who previously worked for Faro Automated Systems.
On the chariot line self-replication routines. I came here thinking this was a rendition. When your people took me, I thought, about time. I've been trying to swallow the guilt every day since.
Would you like to take a moment?
No. I really hoped Zero Dawn was a way to undo it all. My work. Yeah. I'm sorry to say I was ever proud of it, but tech could really sell a concept, and in the labs, in the light of creation, that first test run, when you saw they understood their own structures, could rebuild themselves from memory and light, there were no limits. God, there were no limits.
There's no limits, guys. Interview.
I'm sure you now understand the urgency of why we brought you here, Ms. Okilo.
Captain Okilo, are you trying to thank me for not resisting?
I believe we could negotiate a diplomatic solution.
When it came to my country's lithium, it was always a swarm that would be sent to negotiate. Metallurgic International, U.S. Robot Command. The markings changed, but the robots were the same.
You have had considerable experience in human-robot conflict.
Yes, and I've got the prosthetic limbs to show it. Yet I continue to face this horror, even though the challenge was great. Cyber warfare. I thought Zero Dawn would be a Manhattan project to generate the deactivation codes. With the resources I had, I estimated code-breaking to be a hopeless endeavor. I was almost looking forward to being proved wrong.
Unfortunately, your estimation was correct.
As your General Hera said. So then, you did not bring me here to commiserate. What is left?
I think I'm just going backwards. I was just trying to see what this leads to. Leads to a whole lot of nothing. Okay, we got one more. Here we go, bounce.
Fly. I mean, literally. Remember the Odyssey? That multinational heap of space junk that's been in graveyard orbit since 57? That went nowhere real slow, and you have to get somewhere real fast. Do you have any idea the immensity of the challenge to prep a new colony ship in time?
To be clear, I'm not a worker on the project.
Do you even understand how few people it could save? The whole generation ship concept is not gonna happen. It's the first thing you'd abandon in favor of embryonics. For that kind of storage we're talking, a lot of bulk, a lot of power, a lot of resources. So even if you do it, even if you build it and point it at Sirius X, there's no room for people on that thing, all right?
If you could try to remain calm.
But you people are crazy if you think you're getting off this rock. No one's getting off.
Medical.
Yeah, that dude was going crazy. I would too, man, like... Just imagine this, knowing the world's going to end. Like, you can't do shit about it. Like, fucking, that's fucking horrifying. It's like, you guys ain't getting, you think you're getting off this fucking rock? No. This is it. I think it'll fit all kinds of people on one ship. It's not going to happen. It's just like, it's crazy to think about the apocalypse, because people don't believe it's ever happened. Some people think it will happen eventually. Like, it's just a crazy thing, because, like, I could actually see this happening in the future, you know? Like, technology's advancing and all that shit, and people might start making robots and start taking over. You just never really know. I mean, that's a lot of theories out there. I mean, one of them has to be right? I mean, something's gonna happen. Maybe not, who knows? But it's just interesting, because, like, I know it's probably not gonna happen in my generation. I'll probably be long gone before the apocalypse happens, but I was thinking, like, if I was in that situation, like, how would I feel, you know? Like, knowing, like, that date on your calendar, like, that's it. Like, it's no tomorrow after that. It's fucking...
insane to think about. Where is this thing at? Oh, there we go. I found it up there.
There is some mistake. I don't understand why I was brought here. Why would you show me these things?
I know that there's already a lot to take in.
In the waiting area, I was seated with a Nobel laureate in biophysics and a monk, I think. He spoke neither English nor Mandarin. It is very strange. And General Harris? What was he talking about? The robot swarm, the Pharaoh plague? I understand it is terrible, but it really cannot be stopped? Why tell us this? There are people in Shanghai, my friends, my family, they have joined Operation Enduring Victory already. It is for nothing? We will all die?
We're going to be able to answer some of these questions.
I just want to know why I am here. It doesn't make sense to me.
You were brought here because of your skill set.
No, that can't be right. I am an art historian. I know Dutch masters, Japanese calligraphy, Gerhard Richter. What does that matter now?
Dang. I'm glad I caught that. I probably would have missed that. See what's behind these. Oh shit.
CB02 data intact. Initiating playback.
Elizabeth Sobeck. You've heard the bad news, and it's all true. The Pharaoh plague is devouring the biosphere. Life itself will cease to exist. But does that have to be the end? What if we could give life a future? What if we could build a kind of seed from which, on a dead planet, life could blossom anew? This is the aim, the hope, of Project Zero Dawn. To create a super intelligent, fully automated terraforming system and bring life back from lifelessness. What would such a system require? At its core, it would need a true AI, fully capable of making the trillions of decisions necessary to reconstitute the biosphere. An immortal guardian, devoted to the re-flourishing of life. We call it Gaia. Mother Nature as an AI. But that's just the core of the system. She will need to be surrounded and empowered by a comprehensive suite of subordinate functions. Think of them as extensions of Gaia's mind. Each dedicated to a specific purpose. Now, these aren't AIs, but make no mistake, each presents an engineering challenge more profound than anything the human species has ever before attempted. Hardware that preserves and then gestates the billions of seeds and embryos from which life will be reborn. The construction of underground facilities to hold it all. And that's just the start. We don't have to build the entire system. The beauty of a fully automated terraforming system is that it can build itself. Now, over the days to come, you'll learn how all these functions, all these pieces that you'll be working on, fit together. How we'll race the clock to execute our harvest initiatives, write the software, build the tech and the facilities. How we'll lock it down and seal it up before the inevitable occurs. But even more important, you'll know how it doesn't end here. How Gaia will generate those deactivation codes General Harris talked about, and build the transmission arrays to broadcast them, shutting down the Pharaoh robots for good. How Gaia will not just build, but imagine any conceivable robot it needs to do its work across centuries. From detoxifying the Earth's ravaged atmosphere and poisoned seas, to the regreening of the Earth from cryopreserved seed stocks, to rewilding the Earth with animal life. And then, when all that is done, how a new generation of human beings, spawned at cradle facilities around the globe, will partake of Apollo, the vast archive of human knowledge and cultural achievement from which they will learn of us, our world. And most important, how not to repeat our mistakes. It's not an impossible dream. It is within our grasp if we work tirelessly and stop at nothing to achieve it. We can't stop life from ending. But if if you will help me, help Gaia, we can give it a future. Join me and help make that future real.
What? That just blew my mind.
The whole Earth destroyed. But then, remade?
Yes. By a machine. A machine of creation.
Elizabeth did this. For life. For us. Why Hades, then? If it was part of Gaia, how did it end up in the wreckage of a pharaoh robot? And why does it want to kill me? And Apollo, the archive of knowledge, what happened to that?
I'm as confused as you are. Maybe the answers lie ahead.
Damn, guys. Go to the processing. I'm going to end the video right here. That was insane, but I believe there's going to be way more to this story. Like, we're just getting started. I feel like this one, the plot's really picking up, and like what she was talking about, like, this is insane. That's crazy. But that's, I mean, that's actually a good idea, you know? I mean, what else do they have? Like, she's trying, you know, at least she's trying. Everybody seems like they're giving up, but she's not. And I like that about her. She's really trying to, you know, have a future. She's like, I know life is ending, but doesn't mean life can't have a future or something like that. But damn, man, that's crazy. But I'm going to end the video right here, guys. It's getting a little long. I know we're still here, but it's kind of like I usually do when we get to this point. I just pick it back up, and then we just keep going. So thank you guys for everything. You guys are so great to me, and I really, really appreciate it. So thank you. And with all that being said, stay different from everybody else. You are witnessing greatness. I am out of here, guys. See you in the next one. Peace. I like how our hair just, look at it. So good. As the wind blows. So yeah, I'm badass. Look at that. Damn, I love it.